This week on Maker Update, a book nook for your body, a table designed for your feet, an extensive lamp, and properly floating your resin designs. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where trash is treasure and mistakes are happy accidents. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. We've got a really fun show for you, so let's kick it off with the project of the week. Renting an apartment means living with someone else's design decisions, and sometimes those decisions don't make much sense. Like this weird closet in Morley Kurt's home for this freestanding freezer. And since it's a rental, there's not much you can do about it. Or can you? He wants to move this freezer closer to the kitchen and turn this space into a cozy secret library. With the freezer gone, he starts dressing the space. And while he has his landlord's blessing for the project, he still wants to make as few permanent changes as possible. The goal is to make it look like a mini Victorian library, so he puts up some peel and stick wallpaper on the walls and these 3D printed coffered panels for the ceiling. Along the baseboard, he created these two custom cabinets for storage. The long one features a tambour door. That's the technique of gluing a ton of thin strips to a fabric backing to create a flexible rolling door. The other cabinet gets a simpler bypass door mechanism, and its job is to hide this cabling for the apartment's built-in sound system. To cover up the gaps in the wallpapered corners, he installed these trim pieces, and those came to bite him later on when he went to install the rest of the shelving. Since they're all different, he needed to make individual cutouts for each of the shelves so they would fit flush. Some faux neon LED strip under each of the shelf lights the space, and it's nearly complete. But only nearly. To make use of the dead space between the two cabinets, he's installing this secret compartment that rises up on a linear actuator. To toggle the mechanism to raise the compartment, he 3D printed this dragon bust that hinges open to reveal a toggle switch, just like Batman would have. It's a really fun build, a great feature to add to your house, and this video is chock full of different techniques and design challenges. More projects. Speaking of design challenges, Simone Yetch has a great video on how she built this coffee table with a rotating top. The idea here is to create a table that can flip into an ottoman, while also creating some additional storage space near the couch. This almost sounds simple until you start working out the details. Since the center of a table is what tends to hold the whole table together, making it spin means that that structure needs to live elsewhere. There's also a hidden catch mechanism that allows the table to lock into each of its two positions, and the pivot point is offset. That way the table is high enough to act as a light task table in table mode, but is flush with the couch when used as an ottoman. The rotating compartment also has a hinged lid for storing blankets, since those don't mind being tumbled around. Robert Skinner wants to make this kinetic lamp. It's a sort of extending scissor hinge mechanism, and the further you extend it, the brighter it gets. And just to make things more difficult, he wants to design and build the entire thing in just 24 hours. All of the linkages are made from transparent acrylic, since he can laser cut that fairly quickly, and then can sand it to diffuse the light. He made this jig to make the curved end caps by heating the acrylic and keep the curve consistent, and the parts really started coming together. And while he blew past his 24-hour deadline, the project had enough momentum that he couldn't let it go. He made this concrete base for the lamp to stabilize it on the floor, and it also houses the sliding mechanism for the scissor, which drives a rack and pinion to turn the dimmer knob. Several days later, the lamp is complete and it works as well as it looks. Check it out. And if somehow you haven't already seen this video by Marcin Plaza of building his own phone from half of a broken Samsung folding phone, now's the time. After finding out how to get all the apps he needs to run on the smaller back screen, he gets to taking everything apart. The idea here is that the screen will hinge upwards, revealing a custom bottom enclosure with a physical keyboard from a BlackBerry. To negotiate that communication, he's added an Arduino Nano. It's a wild journey and worth a watch. Time for some tips and tools over on Adafruit. John Park has a guide on how to turn the Adafruit Fruit Jam into a portable NES emulation machine. What is the Fruit Jam? It's a mini computer based around the RP2350 microcontroller, complete with DVI out, a micro SD card slot, Wi-Fi, and a USB host controller. John's guide takes you through the whole process of installing the Pico NES emulation software, installing ROMs, and getting everything ready to play. From Rybonator, we have a fantastic tip for suspending pigments and other materials in your resin casts. If you just place them in your resin as normal, these materials will likely to succumb to the forces of gravity and end up on one side of your casting. And when you're making dice, that's less than ideal. But if you add just a few drops of white glue to your mixture, it changes the properties just enough that these materials stay suspended right where you place them. It may take a couple of tries to experiment, since adding too many drops can make the material buoyant. Give it a shot. And over on Printables, there's an ongoing design contest for printing mods for your robot vacuum. There's a lot of cosmetic stuff here, like giving your bot a unicorn horn, or a name, or weapons to make it look like your favorite battle bot. But there's some useful stuff too, like ramps to help it get over a tough threshold, replacements for some of the consumable parts, combs to help clean your brushes, and plenty more. And while you're there, you can also see the results of two other completed challenges: back to school and gear for your bicycle. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, Shawn, Hymel is launching a brand new series introducing ROS, or the Robot Operating System. It's not a full-fledged operating system like Windows or Linux, but it's a sort of abstraction layer that frees you up from hard-coding everything you need your bot to do at the microcontroller layer. Instead, you get to control the bot a little more directly. Think of it like the turtle from last week's episode, being able to control it using logo code instead of programming the Arduino Nano directly. This is just the first part of a 12-episode series, and it lays the groundwork for what's to come, while also establishing why ROS is great and where it stumbles. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. A reminder, as always, that you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Big thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible, and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.